You know, it's amazing how much they knew of the universe and the globe in 1828, when these were last brought up to date, isn't it? I say the universe because we've got a pair of globes, celestial and terrestrial, as they should be. Two wonderful pieces of library furniture, but of course they're historical documents. You spend hours. Do you look at these? Do you study them?
Well, I do sometimes. It's interesting to see how the shape of the continents has changed.
Yes. This pair of globes are on their original or contemporary stands, and they are important because they are floor globes. They're proper standing library globes. Yes. One interesting thing, I was looking at these labels and see that they're Carey's maps and globes and papers, printed and brought up to date in 1828. And underneath there's a little slip which appears as if it's been torn away, and it says 1816. And of course what happened was they continued to explore and discover. Almost every week somebody was coming back with another edition. And instead of reprinting everything, they simply, quite correctly, added to it. And what you see there is not really where it's been dug out and underneath maps showing, but in fact what they've done is simply, they used to put a little piece of paper, like a little label, over the top to cover up the date, 1816, and then underneath they printed 1828. And what happens then, somebody's picked that off.
Yes.
And that difference in colour is simply the difference in the colour of the old shellac and the new. These globes are in what I would call virtually perfect condition.
that's interesting to know. We think they've had a hard life.
Yes, I know. Yes. These have this perfect colouring, and they will enable a restorer to clean them properly. Mm. What you must never do with globes of this sort is to try and do them yourself. These can actually be dry stripped, that is, very carefully, the old varnish removed, revealing lovely colour underneath, and then they'll be properly polished. But it's a very, very professional job. I mean, it simply is something that nobody should ever attempt to do. Because they are, as I say, not only of antique furniture interest, but of historical interest as well.
Yes.
They have everything going for them. They've got everything works, evolved properly, and the stands, I'd like to look at those for just a second. These are on a circular frame, which is actually rosewood. This is rosewood veneer. But the legs are actually beech and painted to simulate rosewood. Oh. Now, that wasn't a cheap thing to do. It was fashionable.
Yes.
It actually showed that you were in the height of taste. You knew exactly what should be done. And here you can see where the paint has deteriorated on that leg, showing the beech underneath. It doesn't imply a cheap manufacture at all. It's a very, very good thing to see. These were very fashionable objects. So much so that when we come back up to the apron here, you can see where the marking wasn't quite strong enough in the rosewood, they actually encouraged it and improved it with a bit of paint as well.
Yes.
And then boxwood stringing all the way around. It's a good piece of furniture, and then topped with these wonderful globes. They must have come out of an important house, a good library. I mean, do you know any history of them at all?
They actually belong to my father-in-law, who thinks his father bought them 40, 50 years ago. But it wasn't in the northeast; it would have been somewhere in the south of the country. So it's quite possible that they've come out of a large house.
They are very, very good. Again, you have them insured. You're looking after them for your father.
Yes, we have them insured on the house insurance.
Fine. Can I ask how much?
We have them insured for £5,000.
£5,000. This pair of globes are worth £30,000.
Oh, great. They'll have a heart attack.